I'm like, okay, this is good, this is good, this is...
In the Vision Group's effort to help Ugandans understand and appreciate the content of the national budget read each financial year, economists, NGOs, businessmen, companies, banks, and students gather at the Vision Group offices in a special meeting to discuss the contents of the national budget. Once again, the experts met to take a closer look at the content of the 2023-2024 national budget. The discussions in the meeting were led by the Vision Group Editor-in-Chief, Barbara Kaija. The meeting was attended by economist Professor Augustus Nuwagaba, a lecturer at Makerere University, Kasita spokesperson Issa Sechito, Haj Muhammad, Sempija from Ernest & Young, Jane Narunga, the head of Siatini, John Walugembe, the head of Federation of SMEs, Karen Namagembe on behalf of Civil Society Budgetary Advocacy, Paul Muganwa on behalf of Stanbic Bank, Martha Olwen from UNCDF, among others.
Overall, the budget is very pro-small businesses. A number of affirmative programs have been prioritized, like the Parish Development Model, receiving 1.1 trillion, Emyoga receiving 100 billion. The Invite program that supports medium and small businesses that are doing value addition, about 200 billion will be spent this year alone. There's been the fact that there have been an amnesty for businesses, you know, not to pay penalties and interest, but only to pay the principal. So overall, it's a good budget.
Their emphasis is on internet, extending access to internet, making sure there are websites which are accessible. However, digital transformation goes beyond just internet and accessing websites. We are hoping that together with government and other development partners, government can begin to think of deeper digital transformation initiatives like engaging in e-learning platforms for both teachers and students, because these are transformation activities.
Government is looking at the right things. They're focused on, one, human capital development, which is important for long-term sustainability, export promotion, access to markets, and primarily the sub-focus there is infrastructure, agriculture, particularly agro-processing, agro-industrialization.
Barbara Kaija, the Vision Group's editor-in-chief, thanked the experts for taking time to come and discuss the issue of national importance.
Thank you so much, Professor, for dodging the Kololo to be here. Yeah, and thank you so much to each of you. My happy points are in the budget. I think I like the agro-industrialization, the 5.4 allocated to agro-industrialization. If it's going to do what we think it should be doing, it means probably that we are going to see a bit more of household cottages and a value addition. And if that happens, I think it is the beginning of development for our country, because we have a big population.
Relatedly, members of parliament have spoken out on the 2023-2024 financial year budget. They have welcomed it as a pro-people budget, which is tailored at improving household income.
So I want to congratulate Ugandans for this budget. I'm extremely excited and happy to learn that one of human resource development is one of the priorities to be considered next financial year. When you learn that a lot of money is going to be sunk in healthcare, is going to be sunk in education, you have reasons to smile and celebrate.
I've had health centers that need to be upgraded, but due to their limited resources, we cannot have all of them upgraded. However, we as leaders would wish to have that happen. But we know it can't happen. Even in our homes, we can never have everything 100% perfect. So what we have seen as Ugandans, what we are going to benefit is value addition, more so on agricultural products. That is if really it is put into practice or into implementation. There we shall have no problem.
I want to believe and I want to send a message to the thieves, the use of thieves. Understand that in this country we lose 23 trillion to corruption every year, and that is IGG reports. And from the 23 trillion lost to corruption, $1 trillion is lost to procurement fraud alone. It's high time that we digitalize our procurement process so that we stop the bleeding. This country is bleeding to death because of corruption.
Improving household income through parish development model and EMIOGA schemes. For sure, if we emphasize those ones, we shall have a difference as regards household incomes. Then the second priority was commercialization of agriculture, probably through mechanization, through irrigation. I think those things will go a long way into improving agriculture and also improving productivity.
Allocation of 1 billion shillings to each of the districts for road maintenance is another area that has excited legislators. Story compiled by Adrian Balewanika and Fred Kajubi for the news.